Hello YouTube, how you doing? How you doing? This is Keith Kevin Ken. I'm Kevin. It's time again for another pocket dump deconstruction. It's time for us to look at what I'm gonna stuff my pockets with today. I'm gonna upload this and then run off to work late. Hope all of you are keeping warm and happy, of course, and keeping your pockets full of good stuff. It's Wednesday, January 11th, 2017. Man, we're working our way through the January in a fast pace, aren't we? Wednesday, it's hump day. I hope your hump is a little molehill, not a mountain to climb. Yeah, tomorrow, I'll see you on the other side. We'll do another pocket dump deconstruction when we start to see the weekend in our sights on a Thursday. I give you the date because every single day, every day, we do a pocket dump deconstruction here on the Keith Kevin Ken channel. And today is no different. What you see right there, that's what I'm filling my pockets with. I took a couple of pictures. I'll be posting them on Instagram later on this afternoon. My Instagram is at Keith Kevin Ken, just like this YouTube channel. At Keith Kevin King. Come join the feed. It's easy. It's free. A lot of knives and stuff on it. Also, Instagram's great for knife collectors. Man, there are so many collectors that you see on YouTube. There are also a lot of knife makers, people selling knives, doing auctions. It's just fun. So come follow me at Keith Kevin King and follow other folks too. They're all on Instagram. So let's talk about this pocket dump deconstruction. I'm wearing my Mont Blanc chronograph. And I am so sorry. People say, what kind of Mont Blanc chronograph? It doesn't have a secondary name to it. Bought this a while ago out of Atlanta. But I really like it. You know, it's one of those subtle, classy kind of watches. And I love chronographs. I do. Even though I don't I don't time myself running or anything. Boy, I need an hourglass to time myself running. I don't time myself running or anything. It's just the look is just wonderful. The cigar today is one of the newer Monte Cristo sub-brand cigars, which I really am liking. It's the open. This is the Regatta. And man, I have about three different, types of cigars, from the open series. And I just love them. I'm a big Monte Cristo fan. It's my first Cuban cigar was a Monte Cristo. I still have some of those in my humidor aging. I just smoked one a couple of weeks ago. I don't know if that was included. I think it was included on one of these pocket dump deconstructions. And oh, heaven. A lot of Cuban cigars are, you know, sometimes I'll be with someone and they haven't smoked a cigar and they want to smoke a Cuban cigar. I heard about Cuban cigars. I'm like, you know what? They're kind of strong. And when you've got one in a humidor for 15, 20 years, man, and in a very nice kind of functioning humidor, oh man, it's just, everything is leveled out. It's just heaven. Man, I just talked about something smoking that's not good for your health and called it heaven. Sorry! let's see. I'm laughing because, you know, I'm starting to sound like my grandfather. You know, I've gotten so old. I'm 57. The world is so changed. It's like, you know, you talk about a cigarette. My young grandkids, they put their hand to their mouths. They're so, oh, you talked about smoking. It's like, yeah, it's not good for you. It is not good for you. But in America, you can do whatever you want. That's individuality. Just, you know. So anyway. I don't know why I'm rambling. This is, of course, a Schon design pen. This is the titanium, full titanium version. Let's see here. All right. a thin Coach wallet, one of my vintage Coach wallets. And what we're doing is blended scotch. Let's see, what else? Oh, the coin. You know, this is going to look like the same coin that I carried yesterday. I always carry a silver coin. Now it's a 1 ounce silver coin. See, it doesn't, even though I have shade over it, it doesn't pop as much because this isn't the proof coin. This is the just released uncirculated American Silver Eagle coin from the Mint. The reason I picked it up, first, I just got it in the mail yesterday. Yeah, our regular silver coins. Let's see, can we get this fixed up a little? Probably not. Our regular silver coins look like this. This is our standard 1 ounce silver coins from the Mint. This is a 2016, the last coin that they'll release in 2016 for the American Silver Eagles. Yesterday I had a proof one. It was all shiny. The background was shiny. The thing about this that I realized when I opened this up and I went, oh, I forgot, I haven't mentioned. I did mention that the first year that we got into silver and letting ordinary people like me buy 1 ounce silver coins was in 1986. This is 2016, it's the 30th anniversary. And the reason I keep forgetting is the 10th anniversary special set of coins, which I got. I love these American Eagles. I just, you know, first they're American Eagles and they're silver. And so I have all of them from 1986. Well, it's 2016. Oh, the 20th year, they had a really special set that was limited that I have. I just love that set. It's the 30th anniversary, 2016, 1986. And I didn't even notice because I've been getting these coins. And then I opened this one. You won't be able to see it. I can barely see it. But on the sides of the coin, it actually has 30th anniversary imprinted on it. I'm sorry. I know you guys aren't here to nerd out about coins, but I got my coin in yesterday and I'm going, oh, I forget it's the 30th anniversary. Usually they have these sets that you have to, you know, I have to act like I had to act for my carbon fiber inlaid in Kosi from Blade HQ on Cyber Monday. I had to stay up, you know, at noon, try to be the first one in and all that stuff to get those sets. Now, they just put it on the rim of the coin. But that's why I'm a freak with collecting stuff, but these coins though, they are American Eagle. All of you guys can get them. In fact, and again, I'm not sponsored by anyone. I just think cool things are cool things. If you have kids or grandkids or buddies or sisters and brothers, people at work, you can go to the Mint, usmint.gov, and buy a birthday card with a 1 ounce silver dollar. And then it's cool because you can see what the price of silver is per ounce. How about this? And it goes up and down, obviously. But it's fun. It's fun. Let's see what else. That's the word. The word is basically like the field notes, except a little bit more colorful. Got them from Amazon. Now let's talk about the knives. Man, I'm really getting into these. I start with a bigger carry, and then I've been really getting into these smaller carries lately, especially for work. You know, obviously on the weekends, I always have a big knife on Saturdays because on Saturdays I go down and get most of my Amazon.com stuff. And then on Sundays, I go down for my blue apron, and every time I go down for my packages, the guys in the mailroom say, come on back with the knives. So I get a chance to break out my fixed blades and some of my big folding knives. And they just, man, they really get a kick out of it. But man, this week, it's Wednesday already. I can't remember because I'm old and I forget once I just do something. But I've been doing these smaller pocket dumb deconstructions, these carries. And this is a nice one. It really is. It always starts with, I have an idea for a bigger knife. And then when I start looking at the medium knife, I go, you know, this is kind of nice. Let's see if we can get even smaller. And that's how I came up with this carry. You guys know I love my Crickets. This is the Cricket with the black Nacision show side. It is a sprint run. You could tell it's a modern one because it is a frame lock on this little knife. Isn't this amazing? I do have a video. Someone said, "Blaine, you're going slow on the Spyderco Paloozas." I am. But actually, if you look at the lineup over the past 2 weeks, I have done a number of special new knives, which included a lot of Spydercos. So every week I've been doing these new videos. And Spyderco Palooza became harder than I thought because I have to research every knife because every Spyderco, different dimensions, yada, yada, yada. But we're going to keep doing it. So don't worry. We're still going through Spyderco Palooza. I did all of the flippers. I've done everything. And all of those include the Spyderco Palooza. So, in fact, on this channel, I have a playlist called Spyderco Palooza Thank You, because I started Spyderco Palooza once we hit 1,000. So you can see all of those videos. So yes, I wish I could do it faster, but I wouldn't have a life because I'm also doing the daily pocket dump deconstructions. But we're working our way through, man. I also have told you guys, and I'm serious about it, and you guys might think it's crazy, but if you collect a lot of things, you'll understand it. Man, I didn't know how deep that collection was. It boggles my mind. So we are probably 6 more videos away. I have bunches of knives on my desk that I need to... should I try one of those? Yeah, I mean, it's a messy desk of knives, but I am going to literally do... Now we got to get this back, right? But I have got to do more Spyderco Paloozas. So I will. We'll get them together, I promise you. This is, again, Sprint Run. It is the keychain knife for me. I don't mind with a Sprint Run. I have a handkerchief in my pocket with my keys. And so it doesn't really mess up at all. And a lot of times I put my keys with my knife on my desk at work. But man, I just love this. Oh, it's just so nice. And as a money clip, I've started sometimes using this as a money clip as well. It's just a wonderful with this Spyderco clip on the back. Just nice. It really is. It's the Cricket with that belly. It's a real nice little EDC knife. Opening up packages or whatever. It's just a real, and it looks good too. 1.9 inches, VG10 steel. And again, that's that black Nacision. That's glass fibers, real thin, thinner than the human hair, weaved together in a Nacision pattern. So when you see a lot of Spydercos with their Nacision handles, the vast majority of those are Sprint Run limited edition knives. And Nacision really means the pattern that you see right there. It's a special Japanese pattern used in a special kimono. So that is Nacision. Cricket. The medium knife, this was the last knife really that I picked up once I decided that once the big knife, which is the knife that got away, which wasn't super big, but you'll see that as the knife that got away. And I decided to go with this. I wanted to pick up one of my Mnandis. Man, the Mnandi's nice. You know, I've been handling a lot of knives. I do it every single day. And I talk to you guys about them. So I handle them even more than I used to. I used to just throw them in my pocket and dash. And so now I'm talking about them too. And every time I haven't carried a Mnandi for a while and I pick it out, one of the Mnandis, man, it's just nice. It's just nice. You know, you guys have something, whether it's your car, your house, you know, your son's new braces, whatever it is, your girlfriend's engagement ring. Good luck. Nah, I'm joking. or whatever it is, it's one of those things where you go, now this is why I work. I work for a lot of reasons, but man, I just like the Mnandi. Mnandi is Zulu for very nice. Chris Reeve names his knives after Zulu names because he's from South African. And Zulu is South Africa's native language. Of course, all of them except for one, and that's my only one of my knives I have bought by Mnandi's with Devin Thomas Damascus. I figure if you're going to get a fancy gentleman's folder, save a little, spend a little bit more, and get Damascus. This is Devin Thomas Raindrop Damascus Blade on the Mnandi. I love that it has a little jimping, little gentleman jimping, because I know you're not chopping down trees with this. Ah. Titanium liners. This one has the Cocobolo wood inlays on top of that titanium. This is actually a frame lock. Guys, it is not a liner lock, even though the Cocobolo overlaps a lot of it. It is Chris Reeve's integral frame lock, and it's so smooth. Everything about this knife, the pivot, look at the wonderful titanium clip. Everything is just so freaking classy. See-through construction, easy to clean. Ugh. I really like this knife. I really do. Again, Cocobolo Mnandi from Chris Reeve with Devin Thomas Raindrop Damascus Blade, and just a wonderful knife. It really is. That's my medium carry. I'm such a gentleman today. Such a gentleman. Getting over hump day with a light pocket carry. Man, this makes me happy. I know, I say it all the time. I say I love this, I love that, I love this. I do. You don't have to be, you know, I don't have to only have one, love one thing. I really like the combinations though. That's why I wanted to do a daily pocket dump deconstruction. I see all of my knives and I don't get a chance to go through them and touch them and think about them. And with this daily pocket dump deconstruction that we've been doing over 330 days in a row, and we're going to continue to do it. Let's see how long we can keep this going. But now I get to just go through all my collections and the knives and carry a different combination. And a lot of times when I'm done with it and I'm doing these pocket dump deconstructions, because I just put it together right before coming to talk to you guys. Man, I really like the combinations. That's why I say I really love this, because of the combinations. This is steel. And I have a bunch of knives by a number of makers. This steel is my best flipping knife. It just is. It's the Brous Blades Caliber. Mid-tech. Is it expensive? It depends on where you're at. But yeah, it's expensive. It's more than a Chris Reeve knife. But man, is it worth it. This happens to be one, and a number of them are available on Blade HQ and that kind of thing. What Jason Brous used to do, I don't know if he still does it. I have a big collection of his older knives because I just love them. What he used to do is he would do caliber and he would do a number of them. Let me see. Does he have how many here that he did on this? Yeah. So he did a run of 500 calibers. But then, even though he numbers this, this is a unique knife. So he'll also create these one-offs. In this case, my one-off is because he's taken this wonderful carbon fiber and made this notched in this pattern, which is unfreaking believable. Gives you grip, but it also looks great, doesn't it? So this was one of the special ones, one-offs. Deep pocket carry. It's so light with that black blade. I like that. Ugh, it flips like a dream. It's very super light. Has that liner lock, D2 steel, just a wonderful knife. I'm telling you, it's light. It just flips out there like crazy with that D2 steel. It's just a nice knife. That's my Brous Blades caliber. And the caliber has a 3-inch blade. You guys know that's like, to me, a perfect size blade as well. The caliber, this is the one-off, but he made 500 of them. And you can get them in satin and all kinds of different knife blade types. And I got it blacked out and just loving it. There you have it. That's the carry. That's what I'm carrying over the hump today. I wish you guys the best. Don't forget, thumb this up. Go crazy, man. That really keeps me going. I know I say it every day, but you guys just don't know. I mean it every freaking day. It just, to know that you guys are out there. Thank you for your comments as well. I'm bad at responding, writing, and I know I have to get that going. I get it, but life does happen. And when you're 57, I spent a lot of time missing out on life to get where I am career-wise. I'm not missing out on life. I don't want to disappoint you guys, but I'm going to have life, okay, amidst work. But, man, you guys are important. That's why I do this every single day. I will be doing a lot of special videos. I'm tapped out with all the knives that I made, the special ZT zero-tolerance knives. I didn't expect Spyderco to drop 2 new knives on us so early. But this Friday I get paid again. That means I have a knife budget. We'll see what new knives we have, which means new videos, new Instagram posts, all because of you guys. So thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. I am on the Spyderco Paloozas as well. Get ready, man. Please thumb this up. Go crazy. It keeps me going. It is the fuel. Share. Let people know that we're out there. Also, man, hit that subscribe button. We are making our way to 2,000 subscribers. 2,000, we can make it happen. And once we do that, I'm giving away 2 brand new Spydercos. At least one will be a sprint run, okay? And we'll, as we get closer, we're not that close right now. As we get closer, we'll come up with the rules and everything. Let's see, what else? Oh, I will be posting this on my Instagram at Keith Kevin Kim. But you know what? This ain't Instagram. Oh, no, we talk about the knife that got away. And that's where this happens. That's why I call it a deconstruction. A lot of people can say, this is what I care and put it on the desk. First, it's going to have a lot of variety in it. But second, I want to tell you how I got to there. And I started with this because I hadn't had an automatic. Yeah, I'm doing two-handed. I'll tell you what, you get a Microtech. You get a Microtech, a Scarab, and see how many times you don't do it. They're stiff. Some Microtechs are really stiff when you bring them back in. But that's okay. As long as they flip out like that, this is the crucial part, having your blade ready, okay? This is just a wonderful blade. It really is. It's the Microtech Scarab, QD Scarab. Now, they have the just regular Scarab, and of course they come in like most Microtechs in all kinds of colors and stuff. A regular Scarab doesn't have the texture within these aluminum structures. So here we have this pebble texture, which gives you a little bit more purchase when you have it. You know, it gives you a little bit more grip, but it also looks nice, feels nice. The Scarab is actually 3.5-inch blade. This is a black anodized blade. It's Tanto, which I love. L-Max steel, very good steel. This is called the out-the-front automatics. It's double action, which basically means what you just saw me do. You push it out with the lever and you bring it back in with the lever. There are single actions as well. Of course, it's out the front because it is out the front. Single actions go out like this, and then you have to either cock something or do something to bring the blade back in. The Scarab is just nice. Man, Microtech's wonderful. I have a video of all my Microtech automatics, except for two of the newer ones. But it's still about 11 knives, and it's fun. I know some of you can't have automatics in your state. I can. But let me just say, watch the video. You'll enjoy it anyway. You'll enjoy me having fun. I really like the Scarab. Here's the deal. It's 3.5-inch L-Max steel with that tanto blade. But I'll tell you, even though it's a big blade, it carries nice. It has, of course, all of the Microtech automatics have a glass breaker. This has the newer one. The older one comes just to a point, steel point, and sometimes grabbing your knife, you can get stuck a little bit. And then they got it, and now they have like a ball bearing head. Still breaks glass, just now it doesn't hurt you. What a wonderful construction. The thing is, it's so thin. It's thinner than my Ultratech. And so it really carries nice and thin. It doesn't take up a lot of pocket space. But look at that wide blade. It just snaps out there. Oh, it's my Microtech. I hadn't carried for a while an automatic. And so I got a determined to carry the automatic. And guess what? Now it's the knife that got away because I wanted to go a little bit smaller. I was thinking this, this, and that. But that's the knife that got away. It's my Microtech Scarab Cutie, 3.5 inches, L-Max steel, tanto blade. And that's it, folks. Hey, you have a perfect day. Stay warm, stay healthy. Find just a little bit of time. I know most of you are men. Almost all of you are men watching this. And I know you're busy, you're working, you're striving, you're doing all kinds of stuff. Spend a little time to just for you, okay? Just every day, spend a little time for you, man. I missed about 50 years of doing that. I would have been a whole better person to my family, to my friends, to myself. All right? Do that for me. You guys have a perfect day. Keep those pockets full. Goodbye.